You want to know which ND filter to use with your drone in which situation? Coming right up. Bonjour and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Céline, I'm a Belgian TV journalist. Together, let's find out which ND filter you need to use with your drone.
ND filters reduce the amount of light entering the lens without affecting the colors. ND filters can be almost transparent, slightly gray, or nearly black. When using ND filters, you have better control over the aperture and the shutter speed. The DJI Air 2S has a constant aperture of 2.8. In one hand, it makes great footage in ideal light, but on the other hand, when it's too bright, you can have washed out or very light footage.
And let's face it, it's impossible to correct those kind of footage post-editing. So the exposure is very important.
There are three elements that a camera takes into account to determine the exposure of your photos: the shutter speed, the aperture, and the ISO setting. We can't do anything about the aperture, so let's move on to the shutter speed. It is the length of time a camera shutter is open to expose light into the image sensor. Are you still with me? Imagine the shutter speed is like a curtain in front of the camera sensor. Slow shutter speeds allow more light into the image sensor and are used for low light and night photography. The longer it stays open, the more light enters and the brighter the footage. While fast shutter speeds help to freeze motion, it is expressed in fractions of a second. The shorter it stays open, the less light enters and the darker the footage. Now, there is a strong relationship between the shutter speed and the frame rate. The cinematic shutter speeds rule is easy. Shutter speed should be set to double your frame rate. For instance, you want to film at 25 frames per second. What's the double of 25? Oui, bravo, 50. You should set your shutter speed at 1/50. If you want to film at 24 frames per second, you should set your shutter speed at 1/48. But most cameras don't have the option to shoot at 1/48, so if shooting at 24 frames per second, set the shutter speed to 1/50. If you're recording at 60 frames per second, you should ideally set up your shutter speed to a value of 1 to 120th, and so on. Now you know how to properly set up the shutter speed. The recordings during daytime will usually look way too bright, and that's when the ND filters are coming into action. The ND filters we have in our box is the usual ones: ND4, ND8, ND16 and ND32. The higher the number, the less light the filter lets in. This means that ND32 filters let in the least amount of light. They are for use in very bright locations. The best light for using ND filters is very bright sunlight, like today. If it's very sunny outside, you might need an ND64 filter. With an ND filter, you can compensate for slow shutter speed. You can get rid of overexposure and capture very smooth movements at the same time.
Now, let's see together the four ND filters and the context of their use.
Now that you have mastered the use of ND filters, tell me which one will you use? Tell me everything in the comment section down on dessous, below.
Don't forget to smash the like button and the subscribe button in order to see each other again soon. Take care, les amis. Salut!